Traffic instability problems may present in different ways. For example, traffic may only route between one pair of on-prem and OCI VCN subnet ranges, and then route between an entirely different pair of subnet ranges, only to switch back. On occasion, traffic may flow only between one pair of on-prem and OCI VCN subnet ranges when other ranges are present. And sometimes traffic may route as expected, but drop on or around the hour every hour. This presentation covers the common causes of traffic flow instability that you may encounter when you first deploy a new VPN tunnel or make changes to its traffic-related configuration. Troubleshooting tips and support engagement best practices will be addressed as well. Let's begin by discussing causes of traffic flow instability. Most traffic flow instability stems from simple configuration issues. An incorrect routing type choice is the most likely source of the problem. However, phase two negotiation settings, most notably the Diffie-Hellman or PFS group, and the phase two lifetime could factor into an issue as well. Let's review common strategies that you can employ to troubleshoot traffic flow instability. First, let's locate our VPN tunnel. To proceed, we need to access the OCI console in a web browser, then navigate to the networking section of the console, locate the customer connectivity header, scroll down and click site-to-site VPN. This brings us to the IPsec connections page. Click the IPsec connection associated with your tunnel. Then click the tunnel itself. To begin the actual troubleshooting process, use the tunnel's edit button to expose the tunnel's current configuration. Here, notice the routing type options. The BGP option is well understood. However, ensure you only employ the static option when your CPE employs a dedicated interface that encrypts all traffic that reaches that interface and sends that traffic over the tunnel. This type of CPE configuration is paired with a single any-any encryption domain, and we assume any-any on our side. If you select this option and your CPE uses site arrange-based policies to match and encrypt traffic, problems can occur. Negotiation may fail outright when your CPE passes a site arrange-specific encryption domain and we pass any-any. Your CPE may be able to route traffic associated with one pair of on-prem and OCI VCN subnet ranges, or if you have multiple on-prem and OCI VCN subnet pairs defined as encryption domains, traffic may route between different pairs at different times. To prevent such a problem, select the policy-based routing option. Then use its special associations dialog to populate its on-prem CIDR blocks and Oracle Cloud CIDR blocks fields with the same subnet ranges passed by your CPE's encryption domain configuration, which, depending on your CPE type, could be labeled traffic selectors, proxy IDs, access lists, and so on. Next, you may want to match your CPE's phase two negotiation settings here in the OCI console to prevent potential issues with Diffie-Hellman group configuration. To proceed, you'd want to scroll down, click Show Advanced Options, scroll down some more until you see the phase two IPsec configuration section. Here, click the set custom configurations checkbox, then use the associated dropdown fields to match the Diffie-Hellman group and the encryption algorithm and authentication algorithm at the same time. And while you're at it, you want to ensure that the IPsec session key lifetime is set to 3,600 seconds. And this same lifetime value, 3,600 seconds, should be set on your CPE as well. Of course, once you're done, be sure to save your changes. I won't be saving my changes since this is my demo tunnel. If traffic instability persists, OCI customer support will be happy to help you optimize tunnel and related settings for your particular environment. Prior to engaging with support, please familiarize yourself with the following support engagement best practices. When contacting support, be sure to describe the history of your tunnel deployment, recent changes to your CPE's traffic-related configuration, if applicable, and instability characteristic. Additionally, be sure to provide the following information as well. Your VPN tunnel OSID, your CPE make, model, and software version, that CPE's phase one and phase two negotiation settings, and most importantly, your CPE's encryption domain or equivalent traffic selector configuration. Thank you for viewing this video on VPN traffic flow instability. Ensuring your tunnel is properly configured is critical to ensuring stable traffic flow. So take the time to review and implement any applicable changes we discussed, and reach out to OCI support if further assistance is needed.